Good afternoon. You're watching Proactive London. Alex Walker is with us now from East Star Resources after reporting positive results from analysis of rock chips collected there in Kazakhstan. We're going to get you to explain the geology of all of this. So, Alex, what do we need to know? Good to see you again.
Yeah, good to see you, Katie, and thanks for having me. Yeah, we're very excited. Look, rock chips is just one of many measures that we use to try and assist with our targeting. So we're very, very pleased, though, to pick up the sorts of grades that we have. Just for everybody listening, so one of our targets, Talovskaya, had a rock chip of more than 17% copper, more than 10% lead, 0.4% zinc, 0.37 grams per tonne gold, and 121 grams silver, which is just absolutely phenomenal. I don't know if anybody here recalls the discovery of De Grussa from Sandfire Resources out of Australia, but it's that sort of very high grade, 22% copper equivalent that we've received in the rock there. So it's very, very exciting. Talovskaya is an old mine that had very similar mined grades that's now within one of our new licenses. So no doubt that'll be a priority target for us to follow up once we've finished processing all of the electromagnetic results.
All right. You seem pretty confident that you can emulate other successes out there.
Well, that would be very nice. I think that's a pretty extreme example. But, you know, one of our theses is that we've got two of these mines, Talovskaya and Pokrovskaya, within our new license and a number of other areas that have shown, you know, considerable promise. But, you know, these two areas were really interesting because the mine grades were so high, 20 to 30% copper equivalent, you know, the general thought process is that the lower grade stuff has been left behind. And this could be, you know, 3 or 4 or 5% copper that they just didn't bother with when you had such high grades in the mines themselves. So whatever it is, we feel that the areas are underexplored. And so certainly, you know, rock chips give us a geochemical signature now, along with the historical geochemical work, which you know, we already had much of, and now our geophysical results as we process the EM. So once we overlap the two sets of results, we'll have our priority targets for drilling for next year, and it's pretty exciting.
Mm-hmm. And when are you likely to know more?
So we are still gathering some additional historical data. We will do additional field visits this year, and we'll be processing the EM data over the course of the next month, probably month to 2 months. So I expect that we'll put out, you know, an updated announcement really listing our priority targets and why before the end of the year, and then it'll just be logistics from there. But, you know, this has always been a slightly more, should we say, speculative part of the portfolio, purely from the aspect that we didn't have the same amount of data on it as we did with our gold projects. But I suspect, and it certainly feels to me like it's moving up in priority very, very quickly, given these results.
All right, we'll leave it there. Alex Walker, thank you so much. Come back when you know more information. And that is all from us today. Thank you very much indeed for watching Proactive London from East Star Resources. It's Alex Walker.
Thanks, Katie. Take care.